Hello. A friendly game, no longer a pressure. Maybe time pressure, so. What the hell is this? One of the worst hands I've ever had. Okay, captured Nazi is quite an obvious headline. I don't even want to think what happens if I'm purged. No need to thinking any longer. Yuck. Okay, actually this is maybe the best result I could count on. I rolled a 4. It's better than if I had rolled a 6. Can't do much about Europe. But I can do things about Middle East. Okay, let's score Middle East. I think I'll hold defectors. Mm-hmm. Oh no. So I'm losing Asia as well. And this is a stable loss. Let's hope he doesn't coup and leaves the DEFCON at 4. I may risk couping South Korea with the China card in this case. If he doesn't go to Thailand. Okay, getting off such a trouble is a kind of skill. Now let's check whether I could do it or not. I really wonder whether he noticed. What was it like? 4, 3, 3, 2, 4. 1, 2, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay, this is a 0 I didn't mention. And that was quite an unfair. Plus, the only Soviet card he played turned out to have no effect at all. Ah. And he degraded DEFCON. And he had this, come on. At least this failed. Okay. Now I'm very angry. No good coup targets for him. So I'm gonna take France. Actually, not that bad. On the other hand, I'd have to put more attention in France. No, no event first. This way, Europe should be stable as a stably fixed. Okay, but I feel now I can fight for Asian domination, or at least for stopping his domination there. Pakistan plus India plus Burma. That's for starters. He's going, okay. Yeah, why the hell not? Defectors, a hold card for one more time. Suez crisis for an event sounds not very bad. Yeah, let's keep it in the deck. Okay, I'm not really scared about this region. Let's take a chance and gain Milops. Okay. Comic-Con to Iran and probably France. Asia is relatively safe. But I have to over control North Korea and Pakistan if he gets access. He gets access. Yuck. Okay, so over control here time. Fidel, probably the event. I feel Afghanistan can be an important country one time or another when it comes to count non-battlegrounds. I'm still not sure about Fidel. What's the count in Asia? He has one more. Okay, let's do it. I'm already a little crippled. Most annoying thing is that I'm crippled in Middle East. Oh, but this is sort of good news. No flipping Laos, Cambodia, just gives me Asia. And another poor hand. I normally headline socialist governments, but there are decent targets to it. Can I really fight for Asia? Not really, he has the China card. What can he do in Asia in the Pakistani war? But if he does, I really can't stop his domination, so let's risk it. Alright. Okay, I don't like this move. Not at this stage of the game. Now that Asia is played, this can be activated, and let's go here very fast. Yes, I know, I'm giving up my military operations victory points. But I have to count on dice if I cannot count on cards. Come on, what the hell is this I have in hand? Oh my god, no! No, why are you rolling such things when I have such hands? Whew. At least that was an answer. But still, disgusting. Distal. Yep. Whew. Roll high, roll high. No, no one! Come on, why? Just everything above this would be decent. I know he rolled one as well. But come on, he has ops, so I should have rolls. Promozon disactivated. Norad activated. Too late. Socialist government's gone, so Cambridge 5 gone. Okay, Europe scoring now. One of his cars is Nasser. About the other one. If he's forced to place Nasser, even if he discards, forcing him to play Nasser is actually a good thing because he didn't go to Egypt. So he's gonna lose Egypt and access to Libya. I already lost once against him. Oh, he didn't have this. Oh, and his space is decoy. Things start looking not bad. Still, I have to take risks like this. Okay, he grabbed it. He couldn't know it, but he did. That's a nasty hand, actually. Anyway, flower power, an event. Okay, at least he got rid of this card. Whew. Okay, Norad is activated, but not as painful now, even if he goes to France. I'm certainly better post than his in South America. Cool, Colombia, yes. Cleared. Okay, it doesn't really affect Middle East now, shuttle diplomacy, I mean, so. Nuclear subs last action round, probably. Maybe containment. If I get some time, defectors to space, but... Oh no, you don't. All in... No. This is not what I meant. I'm nervous already because of what's happening here. Whew. It was risky. It theoretically shouldn't have worked, but it did, and I'm very glad it did. Okay. Can't afford spacing defectors. Oh, how nasty this game goes on! I don't even have a 4 to get into West Germany. He has a 4, of course. And the Ecuador move is something I really didn't like. As an access to Peru and Chile, it's okay. As controlling, certainly not. Oh, a nice influence, actually. Okay, so good news are he starts playing. Let's say I don't like the moves he plays. It's quite suspicious. But I can't see the remaining scorings. in my favor. Come on, you have this Nasser. And you want to trigger it before Sadat. Very strong flower power, it turns out. It's really a rarity that flower power gives 4 victory points before the turn 4 ends. Finally. Come on! Nasser flipping Brazil. Unbelievable. Okay, Junta, cause what else? The best headline I can play with this hand. Okay, I'm lucky he drew a shit like this. Actually, this is a very, very good hand. On the other hand, it may turn crippled. I have points to prepare OPEC scoring. I feel he has a dilemma. He would probably risk coing Argentina, but with Junta in my hand, even his success doesn't give him much. Actually, I think the best he could do is rely on Venezuela, but still not convincing. Come on! I was joking about this. Okay, Alliance for Progress for 1 victory point is quite acceptable. So let's attempt to coup Mexico first. And give it to him. And give him Norad, which I forgot, but it's still not as painful. Now we have priorities here. It's not a good position and good moment to play OPEC for the event. The map requires attention first. of course Libya should be played into, because otherwise Sadat cuts off the axis. And there are many things to be done, but there also are priorities. Central America and South America and Libya. Central America is more important than... Okay, not any longer. Now I only need to stay there. So... Yeah, this is the access. And this is also the access. I must remember that I'm playing the entire hand. I think he didn't understand my move. Nicaragua was certainly better, and Guatemala, let's say. Let's wait with Canamacanal returned until he takes it directly. Now let's provoke him to take Iraq. Just to make Muslim revolution more juicy. He wasn't provoked enough. Now OPEC is at 4. Okay, this changes things a little. This starts being decent. I could play Muslim Revolution to Iraq, but... Mm-hmm. No need to be so greedy. It starts looking like something acceptable, but of course still can flip. For example, now okay, not the worst outcome possible. Time for my juicy events in Africa. Central America is like, who cares? Africa is like, who could do it? Just don't tell me you have Usuri. Uh-oh. Good thing is he is going to be the first. Okay, now, so... let's play it this way and check how they respond. My hope is to dominate South America and perhaps play Central America as it is, because ABM Treaty has better targets than this. RLG Angola, yes. And NORAD forgotten about me. By me, sorry. I don't have a good 2-ops card. Necessary, I'm gonna play ABM Treaty for Ops. This is the perfect time for Che. Perfect time for perfect rolls. Oh, and that was good. That threatens realignments against Chile. And realigning Peru is pointless. Now this is a mistake. I'm glad he only cleared it. Okay, time for my Queen Zaire to deny him access. On the other hand, if I deny him access to Nigeria, he is just going to coup Saharan states, so... Central America scoring now. And now we're fighting for Africa, the only non-scored region. Southeast Asia as well, but it's... okay, Africa is now... oh, this can be pretty much spaced. Which region needs taking care of most? Okay, I may have no better chance to grab Central America. With Africa, other cards are pretty much as good. And I forgot about Norad another time, and Venezuela is now vulnerable. Sorry for a moment. Forgetting about NORAD because it's very rare that USA players activate it like this. No reason to score Southeast Asia. Let's attempt to. Now, if it's defected, Norad is still active, so Red Scar. Oh no. Okay. Ouch. We'll do it whenever I get off bird trap. Things to remember, not discard 5-year plan. On the other hand, had I quagmired him now, he would have no problems perhaps getting rid of this. Because under perch there aren't too many good coup targets. He doesn't have to coup, of course, now, because he can wait until I get rid of the trap. The map isn't looking good. The victory points track too. But still, I have to succeed in with puppets. And then quagmire him, and then, well, play something. I won't be able to cash arms race. Because I simply have no cards to perform coups. Unless he triggers Arab-Israeli war. That's a really long thought about a single move. I wonder. He has Kennedy's and he may have some scoring, so maybe he's calculating how can he play them under perch and whether he should discard them or not. Or maybe he got long gunman and he's thinking about showing me his hand. That wouldn't be wise because gunman can just be got rid of and never come back. Or maybe he got striked. Start worrying, this is not online World Cup where we all have contacts to each other. I cannot call him. I don't even know whom to call. If I suspect something's wrong. And I actually don't. I think he's thinking. Or maybe he lost some connection. I'm too lazy to think about follow-ups because my next move is obvious. Pop at governments to attempt to leave their trap. If it fails, arms race and pray it doesn't fail. If I fail twice, the game looks like lost. I really wouldn't like to win this game by forfeiture because it simply started being quite nice and Well, thank you for watching and see you next time.